here to I told Brinkwood in the program the other day that the first time that I came to Hawaii was about 150 years ago. I told him that the second time that I came here to Hawaii was in 1979. And then, you know, I told him, and this is the third time? So he believed the first time. So I feel very happy, sincerely, to be here. And to tell you something, I've been for 3 months now traveling in a tour all over the United States named Santa Fe Chamber Music Festival. And in the past 3 months, I counted. I took 80 planes. 80 airplanes. So I performed over the United States for 3 months in that tour. The last one was together with Tom Jones, Doug Severinsen, Rosemary Cloney, the Everly Brothers, all those big, Mel Torme, and I was in Saratoga, in California, Saratoga, in a mountain there, named Paul Mason, and they put a big festival there, and when I received the news that I was going to come to Hawaii, I feel the most happy person in life. If I am tired or whatever it is, I was supposed to play in the Meadowlands in Jersey with the Fania All Stars, and I refused to go to play with them because I was in a tour. But if this happened to me, you know, with Hawaii, then I don't go to the tour and I come to Hawaii. Here today, and to tell you the truth, God bless all the people of these islands, and God bless you all here today. Thank you. In my first album, which is recorded in Island Records, which is Mango Record, which is Polygram Record, which is Warner Communication, which is Antilles Records, and this is the same company. This is branches of the same company. I did an album named Funky Jíbaro. So what I have in my hands is the national instrument of the island of Puerto Rico. So I've been my whole life playing the cuatro all over the world, and I don't feel ashamed to do it, because this is the one that I feel in my blood, I feel in my heart, and my heart, because I'm 100% Puerto Rican. Second, I know the story of all the Puerto Ricans that came here to Hawaii in 1901 and in 1909. And most of the Puerto Ricans were from my town, Guanica. And I know the story. So, I feel here like I feel home with my family. So today and always, here in Hawaii, you are going to be Yomotoro family, and Yomotoro is going to be your family, your brother. So I decided to make this composition and put the title in the album, Funky Jíbaro. The idea was I pick up the music of Puerto Rico and I put American feeling in the music and make a combination of rock and the music of Puerto Rico, and I put Funky Jíbaro. And this music, you know, this record is selling very good in Europe, like Japan and France, England, Germany, Spain, because I went there already to play and they like El Fucking Euro. I'm gonna play with the help of this great musician here from Hawaii, because this is not the group of Yomotoro, but they're gonna help me today, and I appreciate that very much, and I want you que me le den un aplauso a ellos primero antes de tocar. When I hear that, I like it very much. And say, if one day I have the opportunity to make records, I would like to record that song. And it's a story of a frog. Hey, you know what is a frog? A frog is a sapo. And sapo is a frog. So you say sapo, you say frog. And if you say frog, you say sapo. So you don't have to say sapo or frog, you say it's a small sapo. But this is the story of this lady, Sapa, who was a mother. And this Sapa was having babies. So Father Frog was very worried because he figured my wife is going to die or something is going to happen to her. So when Mother Frog was having babies, Father Frog was making noise from her. So he was very, very nervous. So she started telling him, please go away, leave me alone, let me have the babies. And this is more or less the story of this song named El Sapo. And this song is in the LP Folky Ibero, El Sapo. Thank you.